Indeed, yes, sir. We are with David Brodsky after a great game against Carissa. David, first of all, let's start with yesterday's game. I hate to bring back bad news and bad memories, but what happened? How did you feel when you fell under the sword of that preparation?
It was torture. I mean, I knew that this is probably equal, but I couldn't find where. Like, I saw this queen stack, but I didn't see rook h5, rook f5. That's so hard to find. Like, it just felt, it was really hard.
As a theoretically inclined player yourself, it must feel quite unpleasant to lose like that. How do you deal psychologically with that, and what do you do to recover?
Yesterday, okay, I didn't look at that much chess after the game. You know, I just looked at the opening, saw that, okay, this queen stack is somehow playable. And then, okay, I had dinner, went for a long walk, and prepared a little for today.
Well, today you definitely came very well prepared, because it seemed like you were building a nice time advantage out of the opening. You came up with this idea of g4. It felt like you surprised her. Were you shocked when she played f5?
Oh, yeah. Actually, g4 was kind of prep. I was just looking at some games this morning, and I saw that someone played knight h5 in this game, and white played g4, and it was a little better for white, so I'm like, okay, might as well play it. But then f5 came, and I was like, oh.
And what were your feelings after f5?
I thought it's...
You stopped, you thought about it, you took the piece.
Were
you concerned at all that her attack might be successful? How did you assess the position?
No, I thought this is good for me. But I messed up later on. Like, okay.
And h2. King h2, seven, king h7. Seven.
I think, yeah, queen e2 is. I just. And
you had the right idea.
Uh huh.
To try to get the bishop out, right? But you could force the staking on e3 with queen d1.
Queen d1 is a little.
Because smart. f3 doesn't come with tempo.
Oh, wow. Queen d1 is smarter. Oh, wow. But some other moves are probably fine too, right?
Like, there should be other moves. Queen d1 is just the best move in the position by far.
Oh yeah, and queen d1, and okay, I don't really care about the tempo as long as I neutralize everything. Yeah, I somehow missed knight d4, and then I realized that it's not so clear.
Right, because if it's white's move after queen to d1, you go knight to b1.
Or king h1.
Or king h1, yes.
Yeah.
And that just wins the game.
Which I tried later, okay, here, I was king h1 is best, okay, queen e8, should d4, yeah, no, queen h5 is a mistake, wow. Okay, knight e2, yeah, and here it's probably just nothing special for white, but she spent all her time, which I didn't understand.
Yes.
So I thought I might be able to generate something.
Were you surprised by this move, queen to h5? Were you worried about taking on d4 first? What lines were you calculating?
Oh, queen h5, yeah, I was expecting that.
You were expecting that, okay.
Yeah. What's the deal? Taking
on d4 seems to be much better, at least from an objective point.
Okay, so yeah, knight. I'll probably go knight e2.
Knight e2 and probably take.
Queen takes.
And
something.
Perhaps bishop to e5.
Or rook
to f4, maybe.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, this is bad.
Just to set up the bind like that.
Yeah.
And she played the queen to h5. She was getting super long time down to the last minute.
I thought I could I could generate something. Maybe, I don't know.
You had this opportunity, and you understood that you have to put the queen on g2.
But I should do it with the queen on h5.
With the queen on h5, yes.
Okay, now I have something, right? Because she doesn't have what she had in the game.
She's not in time to double up on the f-file.
Yeah. But okay, I probably still have some resources, right?
It's still close to equal,
but
you have some chances.
Yeah, just didn't realize that this is holding. Yeah, knight e2, bishop e, rook g6. Yeah, rook g6, and I sack the queen, and yes, there's actually nothing.
Everything is just forced.
Yeah, like queen h5 is nice. Oh, it's only move. Now, okay. I can't really. I mean, I could play knight g2, but that's too risky. I mean, she takes a4. I'll never get the knight out anyway,
yes,
because I'm going to get hit with checks everywhere. Oof.
David, a difficult start yesterday specifically, and today, unfortunately, a missed opportunity. But also, it was quite difficult to get your pieces out after you missed them. This is from yesterday. Our producers likes to show our players suffering, unfortunately.
Yeah, that was me yesterday. Yeah.
Yesterday was tough.
yes.
How would you assess your preparation going into this event? Are you happy?
Well, after my game with Andrew, I'm not happy, but okay, that's really tough to find. Like, yeah, today's game was pretty good prep, I think, and yeah, I guess we'll have to see more games.
And what did you do before the event? How did you approach this tournament overall? Did you do any special preparation? Train with any of the players in the field?
I didn't train with anyone in the field, but yeah, I worked on some openings quite a bit. So. Yeah, we'll see. I might have some surprises. We'll see.
Excellent. That's what we like to hear. Who do you have tomorrow, David?
Balaji.
Balaji. Big game. We'll let you rest. We'll let you recover.
Thank you.
And we'll see you tomorrow.
David, we just want to get in a quick shout from our side over here, as we thought that you and Carissa played a great game, in fact, and it was very, very entertaining. So really a big hat tip to you and Carissa both.
Absolutely.
We enjoyed. We yeah. appreciate.
We're happy. We have our gold coins. We're throwing them on the board.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, I played an entertaining game and I didn't get made it today. So that's an improvement.
Wonderful. That's what we all aspire to as chess players.
Not to get made it.
Good luck, David.